What is MBSE? How does it work? And why is its connections to digital twin pivotal for advancing system level innovation? I'm Asmaa, Senior Product Marketing Manager at Ansys, and you're watching the Twin Talks. To answer these questions, I am joined today by Dr. Olaf Kath, VP of Product and General Manager for the Systems, MBSE, and PIDO, Process Integration and Design Optimization Business Unit at Ansys. His leadership includes driving advancement in digital system engineering, particularly in areas such as safety critical systems and interoperability in aerospace and defense applications. Olaf, I'm happy to have you as our first guest speaker for the Twin Talks Season 2.
Good to be with you, Asmaa.
Olaf, I'd like to start with the fundamentals of model-based system engineering. What are the primary challenges that system engineers face today when managing complex, interconnected systems across industries?
All right, so let me start with a little view of what complex products are today. What we see is that products become more and more cyber-physical systems, which are complex in nature. They are oftentimes safety and availability critical. They very oftentimes combine complex embedded software that is connected to the environment. And those products are actually operated in really challenging environments and challenging conditions. If you create these kind of systems, then you typically have multiple work streams. Each of these work streams is complex enough, a work stream on requirements elicitation, a work stream on embedded software, a work stream on physical product design, a work stream on compute hardware design, and so forth, just to name a few examples. And each of these work streams need to be integrated with the rest of the work, the rest of the work products, frequently and consistently. We see oftentimes that each of these work streams is being executed in a bit of a siloed environment, not well connected to each other, using different languages, using different ways to specify the properties and characteristics of the system development. So these are really the main challenges I see in this in this complex world.
How does MBSE address these challenges, and what unique advantages does it bring to system-level engineering workflows?
Yeah, so if you apply a model-based approach, then fundamentally, these federated system architectural models are the ultimate source of truth. So everything, every property of a system, regardless of the engineering domain or engineering discipline, basically finds all properties, all characteristics in these models. They are described really from the highest level all the way in a hierarchy to the details of each and every screw attribute and so forth. The collaboration between engineers in these work streams happens based on system models in general, and engineers with that start to speak the same language. All right. In addition, these models are typically federated. Federation can occur within an organization, within a product development organization, but also across the supply chain. Okay.
And let's talk digital twins. How do MBSE practices complement digital twin technologies, and what synergies can be realized when integrating the two?
If you look at digital twins and the technology behind twins, right, then we see actually two important roles that twins play in a model-based environment. Number one, if you deploy digital twins in the field, right, that helps to connect system architecture models and systems engineering in general and engineer artifacts in engineering to operational data from the field in which the products are deployed, right? So you can have access into operational usage data, data around changes to the product while it's being operated. You can bring back all of these information into the systems engineering iterative cycle, if you want. And the second one is also interesting. If you think of how we are going to validate and verify systems at system level, right, in a digital way, then obviously everything around system simulation, everything around included ROMs and so forth, will play an outstanding role in how we are going to test systems. If we want to test systems digitally, system simulation will be the key method, the key approach to do so.
And with systems becoming increasingly complex, how important is scalability in MBSE frameworks, and how is Ansys addressing these needs?
Yeah, so we are working in many different dimensions in Ansys to support systems engineering in general and model-based model-based approaches in detail. Number one, if you want to deploy a model-based environment to all parts of the organization, then we really need an easy to understand and easy to use systems engineering language. If we want people to talk the same language, that language must be easy to understand, easy to use, easy to access also for the involved people. That's number one. Number two, this obviously requires an enterprise scale system modeling platform that can help manage complex models as such, but also, and this is important, the complex relationships between models, right? So if you federate models from different suppliers, from different teams, from different products in, or systems involved in a product, then relationships between models become key, right? So, and the third thing that I believe is super important is we must be able to connect system models to engineering in a bidirectional fashion. Remember, system models describe the expected structure, the expected behavior, the expected set of requirements, the expected characteristics of a product under development. But engineering still happens, of course, in the engineering world with engineering tools, design tools, and simulation tools to help validate and verify. So we need to make sure we have a smooth bidirectional connection between system engineers on one hand and engineering tools on the other hand that works in both directions. Number three, what are we doing at Ansys to support these developments? So number one, if I come back to that language piece, right? Ansys is part of the standardization work of all of the people and companies coming together to create these kind of easy to use and easy to deploy engineering languages. That's number one. We spend a lot of effort to really make sure that the standards, the standardized language, really fulfills these characteristics. Number two, we are providing a kind of enterprise-grade, super performant, highly scalable system modeling platform, which is based on SysML V2, the new systems engineering language that has been created from scratch, and that is able to, on one hand, provide each and every connected user with a highly usable, let's say, way to access that platform through the browser, through things that people have in place anyways. And number two, that allows system models to be stored in a safe, secure environment. And number three, that allows this connection between system models and any engineering tool that is being used in engineering to be in place in a bidirectional fashion, including digital twins, including deployed twins, and that realizes system simulation as the main means of system V&V activities. So we are really proud to be part of the SysML V2, let's say, community. We have built our, I would say, really enterprise scale system modeling platform on that standard, and I'm kind of really happy to see how this is being adopted by the industry, how we are going to work with partners on several topics in that direction. And I'm also really happy to see how users of this modeling environment really come back to us with super, super nice reviews, super nice, comments, and that people are getting enthusiastic when starting to work with these modeling platforms. Remember, we cannot mandate the use of system modeling to users. We have to make sure people prefer using system modeling tools like the one that we provide over tools like Visio, PowerPoint, whiteboards, and documents.
Olaf, let us now talk about the future and the trends. What advancements in MBSE and digital twins are you most excited about? And how do you see these technologies evolving over the next few years?
Yeah, so if you look back a little bit in history of model-based system engineering, it has been a promise over the past 20 years, if you want, that we will move from a document-based into a model-based engineering environment. My view is that this came in waves over the past years, right? So it was a kind of up and down. It was heroic projects being deployed and then somewhat disillusioned, if you want. Now, with the recent technology advances, with the arrival of SysML V2 and so forth, I think we will see a steady increase, no waves anymore, a steady increase of the use of model-based environments in all of the industries, right? Number one, I think what we see now is it's coming more as a tsunami, not a small wave. It's more a tsunami that we see there. And then talking about these different ways of applying technology there. And number one, system simulation, and we are a simulation company. Simulating systems becomes the main means for systems validation and systems verification. We cannot go and build hundreds of physical prototypes anymore to validate and verify. We have to do these activities virtually, number one. Number two, the arrival of the SysML V2 modeling language for us is a key milestone because this really delivers the promise of being used easily, being understood easily, and also the access to system models in general will be a lot easier with cloud-ready or cloud-based environments like the one that Ansys provides. And in combination with digital twins, we will see a deeper connection between systems as being engineered and systems as being operated.
Thank you so much, Olaf, for being our first guest speaker in the second season of the Twin Talks.
With pleasure. Thanks, Asmaa.